In 2015, Olympic snowboarder Billy Morgan completed the first ever quad cork, which is 5.5 360-degree turns and 4 flips, all done in about 3 seconds. Year after year, us human beings are pushing the limit of what our bodies are physically capable of. As evident in the Olympics, athletes are constantly hitting personal bests and breaking world records, running faster, jumping higher, and becoming stronger. But will we eventually reach a limit someday? Or are we becoming more and more powerful as a species? In August 2009, Usain Bolt reached a speed of 27.8 miles per hour, or 44.72 kilometers per hour, during the 100-meter race at the World Championships in Berlin. In contrast, just 15 miles per hour, or 24 kilometers per hour, would be a pretty impressive speed for the average runner. So, did Usain Bolt demonstrate the absolute limit of the human body that day? Realistically speaking, Mark Denny at Stanford University has predicted that we may be nearing our limit. By comparing long-term statistics of 3 different racing sports in history, he found that the limit may be reached at 100 meters in 9.48 seconds, which is 0.1 seconds faster than Usain Bolt's record. After all, there is a physiological limit that exists. Only so much calcium can flow to our muscle cells at a time, and blood can only deliver oxygen to our body so fast. Let's take a look at another aspect of athletics, swimming. Without the use of any bodily aids, the world record for swimming is held by Florent Manadou, who broke the record with a time of 20.26 seconds for the 50-meter freestyle, putting his speed at 5.52 miles per hour. When Michael Phelps raced a computer-generated great white shark in 2017, he still lost by 2 whole seconds, despite wearing both a wetsuit and a monofin. The science behind swimming involves minimizing drag and propelling the body through the water. It becomes difficult for professional swimmers to continually improve their speed, so they try to find small ways like decreasing drag area by tucking in their bodies more and diving or kicking off with more power. Speaking of power, how much strength can a human have? Eddie Hall won the 2017 Strongest Man in the World competition and set a world record by deadlifting 500 kilograms, while the average male may struggle to lift 45 kilograms over his head. Over the past few years, it seems that our weightlifting limit has been heading towards a plateau, since muscle growth is largely limited by our genetics, which affects our muscle protein levels and our skeletal frame. Now, what about altitude? More than 4,800 people have climbed to the top of Mount Everest, which is more than 29,000 feet high. 8,000 feet is where the death zone begins, and oxygen levels drastically decrease. But not only that, conditions become extremely harsh and avalanches can happen within seconds, not to mention the snowblindness, hypothermia, and even delirium that often plagues even the greatest climbers. But a greater number of people are scaling and succeeding at climbing Everest every single year. In 1990, only 18% succeeded, while in 2012, 56% succeeded. However, this is largely due to an improvement in the technology and resources for climbers rather than changes to the human body. Humans are typically comfortable at altitudes up to 7,000 feet and can acclimatize to altitudes of up to 26,000 feet, after which the oxyhemoglobin in our blood begins to drop drastically. Deaths caused by high altitudes can either be a direct loss of vital functions due to a lack of oxygen or indirectly from stress and physical impairments that lead to bad decision-making and accidents. Now, if you're a fan of figure skating, you'd know that the quadruple jump is considered one of the most difficult moves, which is 4 revolutions in midair. So, a quick timeline of figure skating jumps. In 1882, the first single axel was performed, and more than 60 years later, at the 1952 Olympic Games, the first triple jump was successfully landed. And in 1988, to much of the world's amazement, Kurt Browning completed the first ever quadruple jump. Yet in the 2017 championships, Nathan Chan included 5 of them in his routine and landed them all. So how did we achieve something seemingly impossible? And will we ever live to see a quintuple, sextuple, or even octuple jump? Is it possible to keep pushing the limits of the human body? Dr. James Richards at the University of Delaware studies biomechanics and believes that the quintuple jump is most likely impossible for the human body. The quad seems to represent the physical limit, and to achieve more than that, skaters would have to find a way to shrink their bodies more and jump even faster and higher. Quads require super fast speeds and force, so skaters land with 7 times their body weight, which is why coaches often don't allow their students to even attempt a quintuple jump, as falling could cause serious injuries. So, where are we headed as a species? Even in the past 100 years, we've seen humans grow taller, fatter, and also hit puberty at an earlier age. This is due to a combination of both genetics and nutritional changes. But the big question is, will there ever be a day when our bodies have hit the absolute limit? Or will we be able to keep pushing and, if we somehow haven't gone extinct by that point, evolve into a species of superhumans? What do you think? let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed this video, let us know by giving us a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel and click that bell icon to be notified when we post a new episode. See you next time!